Okay, so I've got a song to kind of go with you, kind of changing maybe the road that we're taking on it. Maybe make a right-hand turn. How about, you know, with what you're doing, but also songs that you maybe mess up or don't know what the lyric says.
Okay.
So this one, I think you'll probably get it, but let's check it out. So, you know, if you look it up online, this is one that supposedly people mess up. All right. And it's the first verse of this.
Okay.
All right.
I got my first real six string at the Five and Dime.
Our DIY is easy to shop. Easy on your budget.
Does it sound like the... I'll see.
I got my first real six string. Bought it at the Five.
Okay. Does it sound like I got my first real sex dream?
Run it back. I could buy that.
I got my first real six string.
Sure.
Played it until my fingers bled. Was a summer of.
So, yeah. So, there's one.
So then, I mean, if that's what you think the lyric is, then the second lyric is like hilarious.
Thing. Yes. Yes. most definitely.
Sorry. All right. Now, what our audience doesn't know is, for whatever reason, because we're gym teachers, we can't figure this out. The audio from my computer doesn't go through so that Pick can hear it. So it's hard for me to play the video and play the song. All right. But Pick, what I want to ask you is if you know a couple of these songs, if you know the lyrics, and then if you can understand where people get them mixed up. So Queen was pretty popular recently with the movie about Freddie Mercury's life, right?
Yeah.
Way before that, you know, I listened to Queen, The Greatest Hits, and it's, I mean, just loaded with good songs. So there's a movie, one of the songs talks about a certain kind of girl who makes the rocking world go round. Do you know what kind of girl that is?
What song is it?
Well, it's the name of the song. It'd be a dead giveaway.
No.
Blank Bottom Girls. Blank Bottom Girls.
Flat Blah Bottom Girls?
Maybe we should look it up. Because I think it's Fat Bottom Girls, you know, like a little bit chunky, round bottom. But I've heard it saying as flat bottom. So, which is a boat, by the way, if you grew up on the Mississippi, you know that. Maybe I'm wrong.
Okay. And it's the name of the song.
I think.
It's Fat Bottom.
Sweet. I was nervous. Made me nervous. I thought you knew the lyrics to like all the songs. All right.
Oh, you're gonna take me home tonight. Oh, down beside that red firelight. Oh, you're gonna let it all hang out. Fat Bottom Girls, you make the rocking world go round.
All right.
Okay.
Well, I think you proved the point and why we're doing this exercise is because people do mix up lyrics. I mean, we all do that.
Right.
So another one from my life, maybe while you think of another one from your life there, Piccolotti, but I didn't even know who this lead singer was or whatever, but Paul Young, does that ring a bell for you?
Yeah, I don't know what sings, but I've heard it before.
Okay. The song goes, every time you go away, you take, do you know the rest of it?
A piece of me with you.
Okay. As a young person, because I was like fourth or fifth grade when the song was popular, I thought it was, you take a piece of meat with you, you know, in case you get hungry.
Okay. All right. So But that one, we're good.
Will you pause it, please? Get, what are you doing? Get out of here. We don't want this. Sorry. You can be a little kid. Sorry.
Ooh. Are we good?
Yes, we're good.
I don't know. All right. So this one, now, once again, this is new to me. I'm just Alicia Keys.
I remember once I was, I had.
So what did she say?
New York, concrete jungle, where dreams are made of, or something like that.
I do believe that's what it is. But if you go back, do you hear concrete jungle, wet dream tomato?
I thought knowing you, it would have something to do with wet dreams.
So there you go.
All right. You definitely get wet dreams after you say that, but the tomato might be a little stretch. It sounds like something different.
Yeah, Are You Made Of is pretty good. Pretty clear.
Yeah. So another one that a lot of people get wrong, it's one of my very favorite songs of all time. Manfred Mann, Blinded by the Light, Revved Up Like a Deuce, as in a car, but many, many, many people think it's Douche.
Okay.
Are you familiar with the song?
Probably, if I hear it. What is it?
I think it takes a while. It takes a while for them to get to the part, but.
So Manfred Mann?
Yeah.
Okay. Shoot. All I got is a bunch.
It doesn't matter.
Okay.
You can do lyrics.
I mean, if you really want to, you know, once again, if you want to get my kind of mind, you're blinded by the light, you get revved up like a dude with like a douche and another boner in the night.
Man, you have a one track mind. That's crazy.
So yeah.
Hey, play it again. Now I want to hear that part.
Okay.
Blinded by the light, wrapped up like a douche, another runner in the night. Blinded by the light, wrapped up like a douche, another runner in the night.
But easily changed.
Yeah. Again, you know, knowing you and your one track mind, I get it for sure.
Yeah. Yeah.
How about Kenny Rogers? Were you a Kenny Rogers fan?
Depends. Which song?
How do you not like all of his songs? I don't know.
But
the one I'm thinking of that lyrics are mixed up is Lucille. You remember that song?
No.
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 You picked a fine time to leave me, Lucille. 400 children and crops in the field. So he's a farmer, right? Crops in the field. What he really says is four hungry children. But since you're getting ready here, let's see if it sounds like 400 children. This is in the chorus also.
In a bar in Toledo, across from the depot, on a bar stool, she took off her ring.
How did he agree to this?
I'd get closer, so I walked on over. I sat down and asked her her name. When the drinks finally hit her, she said, I'm no quitter, but I finally quit living on dreams. I'm hungry for laughter and here ever after. I'm after whatever the other life brings. In the mirror I saw, and I closely watched him. I thought how he looked out of place. He came to the woman who sat there beside me. He had a strange look on his face. The big hands were calloused. He looked like a mountain. For a minute I thought I was dead. But he started shaking. His big heart was breaking. He turned to the woman and said, you picked a fine time to leave me, Lucille.
What did you say that it sounded like? Are people mistaken for
400 children and crops in the field?
Okay, yes, easily. I heard that.
All right.
All right.
I know you're a Madonna fan. We've talked about this, right?
Yes, but I got one here.
All right. Not a big Police fan, not gonna lie. Message in a bottle.
Okay.
This song was on Guitar Hero, man.
This is a cardinal sin of EDM right here.
Someone gets mine. I hope that someone gets my, I hope that someone gets my message in the bottle, yeah. Message in the bottle, yeah. A year has passed since I wrote my note.
All right, what did you hear that last verse?
What's it start with?
Go back here.
A year has passed since I wrote my note.
Okay, that verse right there.
A year has passed since I broke my nose.
Exactly. Exactly. Exact. That's the one, yes.
What's he really say?
It's been a year past since I wrote my note, I do believe.
Okay.
But yeah, yeah, well, you heard exactly what people mistake it for.
All right. How about Madonna, La Isla Bonita? I don't know. I think this is the opening line, but I could be wrong. Last night, I drew, well, I like your version. Play it. Tell me what she says.
The Madonna. Madonna. What? Which one?
La Isla Bonita.
Okay. You know, once speaking of Madonna, you know, Papa don't preach. I drink old.
Yeah. We'll have to give it a spin.
Yeah.
¿Cómo puede ser verdad? Last night I dreamt of San Pedro.
The first one?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll go back.
Last night I dreamt of San Pedro.
Last night I dreamt of San Pedro is what I heard. And that's, I think that, okay. You know, that's the right one. What is it?
What about some bagels? I think she was dreaming of some bagels.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I can hear that.
Last night I dreamt of San Pedro.
Man, this is odd. We could do this for hours.
All right.
All right. All right. Maybe a last one, and we'll, once again, this is another good one. We can come back.
I got to one more. I got to have okay, one more.
We got two more then. I got this one. Okay. Living on a Prayer.
Oh, yeah.
I don't like it showing. Oh, that's because I have the phone.
She says we gotta hold on to what we've got. It doesn't make a difference.
Okay, so the real verse, you know, is it doesn't matter
if we make it or not.
Yes. Okay.
We got each other. Yeah.
So I'll sing it with it. Let's hear.
Okay, you sing.
I like naked better myself.
You really dance like that? Oh, you're shooting the gun.
Yes.
Okay. No, I totally heard that. Now this one, this people might not like this one, our listening audience, okay? I like the song, but it's country, but it kind of makes me think of Sycamore, and I kind of want you, you don't have to say whether it is or not, but it's Martina McBride, This One's for the Girls, okay?
Martina, maybe if I spell it.
And it's kind of in the middle, so I don't know if you want to fast forward a little bit.
Okay.
This One's for the Girls, about 42, your age category. Damn, he lost my mind. Pedal to the metal, let the devil leave me behind. I was way outside the lines, yeah, and I got a...
Tossing pennies into the fountain of youth.
Pennies?
What's that?
Yeah. Pennies. Tossing pennies in the fountain of youth.
Yes.
Play it back. Tell me if you could get on board with tossing their panties. Tossing panties in the fountain of youth.
This is for all you girls about 42. Tossing pennies into the fountain of youth. Every life.
Yeah, I can hear that one.
All right. And the only reason I bring up Sycamore is I hear that on weekends, maybe at MVP, girls in that area get a little, in that age range, get a little crazy. That's all I've heard.
Oh, I have no idea. I don't have any firsthand information for you on that.
Do you have secondhand information?
Not even third hand.
All right. Sounds good. It must be a rumor then.
Yep.
If you like this game, we could play it another time. We were kind of winging it, so it took a little bit to get caught on, I would say, right?
Right.
Once we found our groove, you know, you enjoyed it, you know, whatever. So, might try it again.
Yeah,
for sure.
Anything
to add there, Ryan Michael Piccolotti?
No, I agree. It turned out, pretty good. This is something that we could, like I said, there's a lot of songs where it sounds, first off, there's some like Sting, that Sting song. I can barely hear or understand any of the words he said.
Right. And I think that plays into a lot of this is, you know, like individuals with like an accent, something like that, you know, or the like the Beatles back in the day, what they call that, the whatever invasion. You know, it's a different language, you know, so maybe they speak different dialect or inflection, right. Whatever. But yeah.
Mm-hmm. Or mumbles.
All right. Well, this has been another episode of the Gym Teacher Dreams podcast, and after a little bit of editing from Ryan Piccolotti, I'm sure it'll be great. But as we always say, you tell a friend or two.
And we love you.